Hi, I'm Jamie DeRoy.
And I'm Barry Kleinbord.
And welcome to Jamie DeRoy and Friends. This week, we pay tribute to the long-running shows on Broadway. So to start us off, The Phantom of the Opera is the longest-running show in Broadway history. It's been playing 35 years, now playing at the Majestic Theater through April 16th, when it will finally shut its doors. It won 7 Tony Awards.
I saw it the week it opened, actually, and both The Phantom and I were much younger then.
Weren't we all?
The book is by Richard Stilgoe and Andrew Lloyd Webber. The music is Andrew Lloyd Webber, and the lyrics are Charles Hart. And the original production was directed by the great Harold Prince, who really was a major contributor to its success.
And I went back to see it several times throughout the years. I hope I get to see it at the very end, too, because I went to the 30th anniversary. It was so exciting. So here is a look at Phantom of the Opera. And remember, your last chance to see it will be April 16th.
Unless they change their mind. Next longest running show on Broadway is actually a revival, the longest running revival, which opened on November 14th, 1996, and it had moved from Encores. It's the musical Chicago. And I saw the original production in 1975, and I remember second preview, and there was a character in the show that was being written out that week. And it was David Rounds, who was a great Broadway actor. Anyhow, I can't imagine doing the show knowing that by the end of the week, you're out. But I never forgot his performance. Anyhow, this production has a book by Fred Ebb and Bob Fosse.
And the music is Kander and Ebb.
Yeah, John Kander and Fred Ebb. And
it's directed by Walter Bobby.
Walter Bobby, and the choreography is by Anne Reinking, the late Anne Reinking, who did it in the style of Bob Fosse, who was one of her mentors.
And it is continuing to play at the Ambassador Theater with no end in sight. Here is a look at Chicago.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are about to see a story of murder, greed, corruption, violence, exploitation, adultery, and treachery. All the things we hold near and dear to our hearts.
Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz, start the car, I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl. And all that jazz.
Lion King opened January 13, 1997. It won 6 Tony Awards, including Best Musical and for its incredible director, Julie Taymor. It's now playing at the Minskoff Theater, though it started at the New Amsterdam.
Well, actually, it was Disney took over the New Amsterdam, which had been vacant for many, many years and was only used for rehearsing shows, and they completely renovated it and for The Lion King.
Right, and it's beautiful. And it's still, they even made a book out of it.
It's one of the most beautiful theaters on Broadway. The book, the music and lyrics for The Lion King are by Elton John and Tim Rice. And Julie Taymor's work to this day just continues to dazzle and amaze. So let's see some scenes from it. Opened on Broadway October 30th, 2003. It's the musical Wicked, and it continues at the Gershwin Theater.
It's directed by Joe Mantello,
yes.
And the music and lyrics are by Stephen Schwartz. It won a Tony Award for its book writer, Winnie Holtzman.
And the choreography is by Wayne Cilento.
Yes.
And it's one of those shows that didn't know who its audience was when it first opened. And it turns out to be young girls who take their parents with them to the theater, and it continues to do that. And I think that's wonderful that the idea of going to the theater is passed on from generation to generation. So if you're of that generation, Wicked is the show for you.
There's a strange acceleration in such a detestation. It's so pure and so strong. Becoming popular.
March 24th, 2011, The Book of Mormon has been playing at the Eugene O'Neill Theater. It won 9 Tony Awards the year it opened, including Best Musical.
The book, music, and lyrics are by Trey Parker, Robert Lopez, and Matt Stone, and the show is directed by Casey Niccolo and Trey Parker. And again, a surprising win. I remember when people, you know, the wags on the street were not sure it was going to go, but it's really captured the hearts and minds of people all over the world. So let's take a look at the Book of Mormon.
Two by two, we're marching door to door.
here. Mission is our sacrifice. We are the army of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
On March 20th, 2014, this next long-running musical opened, Aladdin, with a book by Chad Begelin, music by Alan Menken, and lyrics by Howard Ashman, Tim Rice, and Chad Begelin.
And it's directed by Casey Nicola. It won the Tony Award. Well, it didn't win the Tony Award, but its star won the Tony Award for James Monroe Englehart.
Right.
And it continues to play at the New Amsterdam Theater. It's such a beautiful production. When I went back to see it.
Right, because I was with you the first time.
I got to go backstage, and I got to see all these sets and costumes backstage. It's pretty impressive. And it's Disney, correct?
Yeah, it's a Disney show. And in fact, let's take a look at it. Here is a scene from Aladdin.
I think Broadway made history. Hamilton opened. It won 11 Tonys that year, including for its writer, who did the book, the music, and the lyrics, Lin-Manuel Miranda. It continues to play so strongly at the Richard Rogers Theater.
It's adapted from a book by Ron Chernow and directed by Thomas Kail, and the choreography is by Andy Blankenbuehler. And it is, yes, it's a watershed musical.
I'm past patiently waiting, I'm passionately smashing every expectation, every action's an act of creation. I'm laughing in the face of casualties and sorrow. For the first time, I'm thinking past tomorrow.
And I am not gonna wait my shot. I am not gonna wait my shot. Hey, yo, I'm just a country, I'm young, snappy, and hungry, and I'm not gonna wait my shot. We're gonna rise.
Somebody stop, take a shot.
This play opened April 22nd, 2018. It's Harry Potter and the Cursed Child.
It won 6 Tony Awards,
including Best Play.
And the only long-running show that is a play as opposed to a musical. It's written by Jack Thorne, directed by John Tiffany, and it plays at the Lyric Theater.
And one thing we should say about that, this is unusual, because when it first opened, it was a two-parter. It was 4 hours long, and you had to see on alternate days part one and part two. And then when they reopened after the pandemic, they condensed it into one.
To one part.
One part.
I saw it all in one day. I thought it was fabulous.
Well, now you can see it in half a day.
I went back and saw it in a half a day, and it was just as fabulous. It didn't lose anything. Well, here is a look at Harry Potter and the Cursed Child.
Harry?
You're my best friend, Albus.
He'll be all right, won't he?
Of course he will.
I've never fought alone, you see! And I never will!
Town opened on April 17, 2019. It went on to win 8 Tony Awards, including Best Musical.
And the book, Music and Lyrics, are by Anais Mitchell. It's directed by Rachel Chavkin and choreographed by David Newman. And this is one of those unusual shows that started out as an album and then was developed into a full-scale Broadway musical.
I saw it off-Broadway. I think it was at the New York Theater Workshop.
It was, and then it went to London.
Then it went to London, to the National Theater.
Right.
Came back to Broadway.
And this version reflects the National Theater production.
And it is playing at the Walter Kerr Theater. And I just have to say, this is her first musical. To
yes.
come out with your first musical, and it wins 8 Tony Awards, it's pretty impressive.
Show the way.
I'm coming, wait for me.
Show the way.
On July 25th, 2019, this long-running musical opened, Moulin Rouge.
It won 10 Tony Awards. The book is by John Logan, and it's directed by Alex Timbers.
The choreography is by Sonia Taya.
And it plays at the Al Hirschfeld Theater.
Let's look at Moulin Rouge.
No matter your sin, you're welcome here. No matter your desire, you're welcome here. For this is more than a nightclub. The Moulin Rouge is a state of mind.
Six opened on Broadway October 13th, 2021.
And Jamie, do you remember what it was supposed to open?
Exactly. It was supposed to open on March 12th, 2020, the day that all Broadway theaters were closed due to the pandemic. I was scheduled to go that night.
Yeah, I bet you were. but it did finally open, and it was a huge success.
Oh my goodness. It won for its score by Toby Marlowe and Lucy Moss.
It's directed by Lucy Moss and Jamie Armitage.
And it plays at the newly named Lena Horne Theater. Here is a look at Six.
New York City, we are! Listen up, let me tell you a story.
Welcome to the show, to the history.
Time for the cabaret roundup. At 54 Below, The Diamond Series celebrates for 1 week with Jennifer Holliday, star of Dreamgirls. She opens on February 21st to the 26th. On March 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, Amanda McBroom and Ann Hampton Calloway team up in their new show, Divalicious.
For 2 weeks, starting on Valentine's Day at the Cafe Carlyle, Isaac Mizrahi is doing his new show, The Marvelous Mr. Mizrahi.
Over at Birdland, Jane Monheit brings her new show to the club from February 21st through the 25th.
Downstairs at the Birdland Theater on Monday, February 27th, Karen Oberlin is premiering her show for one night called Bewitched, The Life and Lyrics of Lorenz Hardy. To close our show, MJ, the Michael Jackson musical, won 4 Tony Awards and has just celebrated its 1-year anniversary. One of those Tony Awards was for Miles Frost, its star. He continues in the role as Michael Jackson. Yes, the book is by Lynn Nottage, and the show is directed and choreographed by Christopher Wheeldon. And it continues at the Neil Simon Theater on 52nd Street.
And here is a look at MJ.
Looking great, everybody. Keep going.